Hey everyone, it's Zinnia here from OctoStudio, and today I wanted to show you how to make a jumping game on the phone. By the end of this tutorial, you'll be able to make your own game like this one, where the player can tap the phone to have the character jump over moving obstacles. So yeah, let's get started. So I will tap Create New Project, and then I'll start by choosing the sprite that I want to be the main character. You could have the main character of your game be any sprite here. You could even draw one or upload a photo. I think for mine, I will pick this T-Rex. And then you can choose any backdrop you want. I think I'll pick this one. And you know, just move your character to where you want it. So as the first thing in our game, let's get this character jumping. So in OctoStudio, there's this block, the jump block. And if you drag that out and tap it, you can see that that makes the character jump. And if I want it to also play a sound when it jumps, I can go to the words and sounds category, and I'm gonna drag out the play sound block and put it on top. So I'll try that out. And so that's pretty good. Now, one thing is, right now it's playing the sound and then jumping, and if you want it to do them at the same time, you can tap here and change it to play sound and continue, and then now, it plays the sound and immediately starts jumping. Now, let's make it so that the person playing our game can make the character jump by tapping the screen. So to do that, I will go to the when to start category, and I'm actually gonna throw away this when play block, because I don't really need it. But I will drag out this when tap block and put it on top. And so now, when I tap on the character, it jumps. Now, this block actually has some options, so if you tap on this little square, you can choose whether you want the tap to be when I tap the character, when I tap the backdrop, or just when I tap anywhere on the screen. And I'm gonna set it to when I tap anywhere on the screen. So now, as the player, I can make the character jump by just tapping anywhere, because I think that'll be pretty fun. All right, so looking pretty good. We have got our main character working. Now let's add a moving obstacle that the character can jump over. So to do that, I'm going to tap on the Add a Sprite button. And then here, again, you can choose just any character or object that you want to be the obstacle in your game. I think for mine, I will do a ghost. Where is the ghost? I think the ghost was cute. There it is. So then you'll, you know, move your obstacle to where you want it to start out in the game. And to get it moving, you can try dragging out this move block from the motion category, and this will make the character move in whatever direction you put. So to get it to go this way, I can just tap on this arrow and change it to the direction I want. And so now we've got it going that direction. And to keep it going forever in that direction, you can just go to the control category and put a forever block around this, and now it will forever do this block, so it's just forever moving. And I can put the when play block on top, so now when you tap the play button, it starts going. And okay, a couple things to fix. Right now, the ghost is so much bigger than the T-Rex that it can barely jump over it, so to fix that, I'm gonna go full screen just to make the ghost smaller. You may find that you have to make your obstacle smaller so that the character can jump over it, so let me try that. So the size I think is pretty good, but I will also make the T-Rex jump higher to help fix that. So in the T-Rex, oh yeah, I did that kind of fast, but I can tap on this character icon to open up the sprite menu, and then I can just tap on the T-Rex to edit the code for the T-Rex. So I will go to the jump block, and you can actually control how high you want it to jump by just tapping on this number here. So I'll type in something like 70 and just see how that works. So okay, gonna try that out. Ghost is coming. So it's pretty good, but I think I will also make the jump go slower. So you can tap on this shoe icon to control how fast it does an action. A lot of the blocks have the choice to control how fast they happen. And I will set this one to the slowest one, so let me try that. Okay, yeah, now the T-Rex actually has the ability to jump over the ghost. Next, let's make it so the game ends if you run into the ghost, and let's also add a score so the player can get points. So to make the game end if you run into the ghost, in the T-Rex sprite, I can go to the when to start category and drag out this block that says when touches, and you can use this to detect if one sprite has run into another sprite. And so what do I want to happen when it runs into the ghost? Well, in the control category, if you scroll towards the end, there's this block stop. And if you drag that out, it will say stop all. And so if I run into the ghost, it just stops the entire game, and then I can tap play to restart it. So that will make the game stop if you run into the obstacle. And now let's add a score. So you can go to the more blocks category, and you can drag out this block that says change, and then it will say change variable when you drag it out. And if I tap on that block, it makes this variable up here, score, change by one. And a variable in OctoStudio just keeps track of a number in your project. So one way we could make the score work in our game is we could make the player change score by one whenever they finish a jump. So let's just try that out. I can jump over the ghost, and then my score increases by one. And if I jump again, it increases again. And one thing is, when I restart the game, you may notice that the score just stays the same from your last play. So let's use this block set variable to set the score to zero when the game restarts. And I can make that happen by putting the when play block on top. And so now if I get a lot of points in one playthrough and then restart the game, the score sets back to zero. So that's how you can make a jumping game on the phone. And I think I'll make a part two soon and show you how to add more things, like how to add multiple obstacles or power-ups you have to jump to get and lots of things like that, because there are so many things you could add to this game. And so yeah, I can't wait to see all the different types of jumping games you make. And I'll see you in the next video.